CIET-NCERT presents the program Subramanya Bharathi, the nationalist, freedom fighter, and revolutionary poet. When our motherland was struggling against the colonizers, and Mahatma Gandhi was spearheading the freedom movement, a piercing voice from the southern India was heard across the country. This voice kindled the spirit of patriotism among the youth and the old together. The voice of captivating words of poetry was food for thought and action of people from all walks of life. It was the voice which gave sleepless nights to the British. This voice was a volley of gunshots at the oppressors. It was the voice of the revolutionary poet, Theshiyawadi, writer, journalist, spiritualist, and above all, a peace-loving and freedom-longing human, Subramanya Bharathi, popularly known as the Theshiya Kavi in Tamil, the nationalist poet. Bharathi is one of the towering literary figures in Tamil and a freedom fighter who reverberated not only the Tamil poetry and journalism, but also the triggering spirit of the modern poetry, deviating from the conventional way of writing poetry which took kavita to the tongues of common men. It was Bharathi who paved the way for modern blank verse, the Puthu Kavitai. Known as Mahakavi Bharathi to Tamil-speaking world and the Indian subcontinent, Bharathi was born in Ettayapuram of the present-day Tuthukudi district of Tamil Nadu in the year 1882 and lived only 39 years. He had his early education in Tamil Nadu and Varanasi. His stay in Varanasi inspired him to his spiritual quest, and his nationalist thinking began to emerge in his writing and the fight against aggressors. He was the poet laureate of the Raja of Ettayapuram for a couple of years. Later, he worked as a journalist in many newspapers and journals, which include The Hindu, Balabharata, Vijaya, Chakravartini, and the Swadesa Mitran, and India. Bharathi knew more than 25 languages and was well-versed in Sanskrit. Bharathi wrote against the British, their exploitative means of administration and annexation of Indian regions. This annoyed the colonial rulers. Often he was issued arrest warrants, but he would quietly move to Pondicherry, today's Puducherry, which was under the rule of the French. He wrote poetry, essays, literary criticism, and political articles against the British. His poetry upholds the emancipation of women and their rights and the oppressed class. He writes in his Papa Paattu, Song of the Little Girl Against Caste. There is no caste. Let's not discriminate people as upper or lower caste. Bharathi attended the All India Congress session held in Banaras, and on his way back home, he met Sister Nivedita, Swami Vivekananda's spiritual heir. He also attended the Indian National Congress session in Calcutta under Dadabhai Noroji, which demanded Swaraj and boycott of British goods. His works include the lucid romantic poetry, Kuyil Paattu, Song of the Cuckoo, Panjali, Draupadi, Sabadam, Vow of Draupadi, Kannan Paattu, Song of Krishna. Hundreds of patriotic songs and songs against social evils, unfounded beliefs and superstitions. His short stories, though few, are social and philosophical too. He also translated Vedic hymns, Patanjali's Yoga Sutra and Bhagavad Gita into Tamil. Bharathi wrote a national anthem much before the Indian independence.
Vande Madaram Enbom, வந்தே மாதரம் என்போம்,
எங்கள் மாநில தாயை வணங்குதும் என்போம்,
எங்கள் மாநில தாயை வணங்குதும் என்போம்.
Let's say வந்தே மாதரம் and let's bow before our motherland. Bharati also celebrated the independence of India decades before 1947. He wrote,
Aaduvome pallu paaduvome,
Aaduvome pallu paaduvome,
ஆனந்த சுதந்திரம் அடைந்து விட்டோம் என்று,
ஆனந்த சுதந்திரம் அடைந்து விட்டோம் என்று.
Let's dance and sing that we have won a much longed freedom. In 1908, the British instituted a case against V.O. Chidambaram Pillai, who ran a Swadeshi ship company against the British. And Bharati knew he would be arrested, so he escaped to Pondicherry. From there, he edited and published the weekly journal India Vijaya, a Tamil daily, Bala Bharatam, an English monthly, and Suryodayam, a local weekly in Pondicherry. The British tried to suppress Bharati's output by stopping remittances and letters to the papers, and the publication of India and Vijaya were banned in India in 1909. He was unyielding and unaffected and continued his writing against the British, and his poetry made impact on all sections of people. During his exile, Bharati met the revolutionary leaders of the independence movement, Aurobindo, Lajpat Rai and V.V.S. Iyer, who had also sought asylum under the French. Bharati assisted Sri Aurobindo in the Arya Journal and later Karma Yogi in Pondicherry. When Bharati entered India near Cuddalore in November 1918, he was arrested and imprisoned in Cuddalore Central Prison for 3 weeks. He met and had a dialogue with Gandhiji in the year 1919, and Gandhiji was moved by his speech and actions. The indomitable Bharati was stricken by the Mylapore temple elephant, who he was feeding every day, and this added to his ill health. And the great song of India breathed his last on the 11th of September 1921. The nationalist and the revolutionary soul who longed for freedom could not live to see our motherland attaining freedom from the colonizers. He loved to see India an independent, socially, politically, and economically developed community, not simple as a country, as he described our land as Bharata Samudayam, Bharatiya community. His spirit, poetry, and thoughts live in letter and spirit, and continue to inspire us, keeping the patriotic spirit among us. Let us strive to keep up the Bharata Samudayam, Bharatiya community, vibrant, and make it a Vishwa Guru as a tribute to the great son of India. Long live Subramanya Bharati. Subramanya Bharati, you were listening to this program. Script and academic coordination, Professor R. Meghanathan. Program Coordinator, Dr. Rajesh Kumar Nimesh. Technical Coordination, Bati Lang Lingdo. Recorded by Shanu Muksim and Vikas Sangwan. Narrated by Ajit Horo. Singers, S. Purnima, Education Department, Puducherry. Vaishnavi, Teacher, Shekhilar Government High School, Puducherry. Students, Surya Darshini, Steffi, Darshini, Saktilaya and Vaishnavi, Shekhilar Government High School, Puducherry. Production Assistants, Tanu Gupta. Directed and produced by Vimalesh Chaudhary. We gratefully acknowledge Sa Re Ga Ma Pa, where from the song Oddi Viliyadu Papa is taken. This program is presented to you by CIET NCERT, New Delhi, India.